Hello, welcome to my video. This video will show you how to create an accordion menu in Articulate Storyline. I want to show you the final product first to you, and then we will jump into the development procedure. So as you see here, there are three buttons or three accordion menus. You can add as many buttons as you want, but I just wanted to pick three because it's going to keep it short and it's just an example. And before I get started, I also would like to say that you will be able to download this raw file and the link will be in the description below this video. Let's take a look at how this accordion menu really works. If I click the button number 2, there will be this content area that you can type your text or add your image or embed your videos, any kind of content. If I wanted to click button number 3, it will be the same. And there is this little indicators. It could be a triangle or plus shape or different type of shape that indicates which one of these accordion menu is expanded and which ones are collapsed. And here it says like button 3 is now expanded, and I can keep navigating between the buttons. And let's move forward and take a look at the raw file to see the triggers that I used to build this interaction in Articulate Storyline. To make this interaction happen, I created three different layers for each one of the buttons. And you see here, my first layer is called base layer. The second layer is called button 2 layer. And the last layer is called button 3 layer. And I would like to show you what components are used in each one of these layers. And first, let's take a look at the base layer. If you take a look at the timeline, I have different shapes and elements. I had a text box for button number 1, and then button 3 for the base layer, button 2 and button 1 for base layer. And other shapes that I had on this layer are the triangles that indicates if the button is collapsed or expanded. So I called them button number 1 base layer triangle, button number 2 base layer triangle, and button number 3 base layer triangle. I added similar shapes to the button 2 layer, and the first one is the text box for button 2 layer, and the second type of shapes that I added is called button. For button 3, I used button 3 on button 2 layer and used a similar naming protocol for the other two buttons. And for triangles, I called, for instance, button 3 triangle on button 2 layer. So I had three triangles for three buttons and one button text. And finally, the similar shapes and the similar naming protocol was used to create button 3 layer. This is how I created shapes for each one of my layers. And we will take a look at the triggers and states that I used to make the interaction happen in the next section. To show you the interactions, I would like to start with the base layer and take a closer look at the triggers. In the base layer, what I want is for the users to be able to click button number 2 or maybe button number 3. Whichever happens, the accordion menu should open up, and then the triangle would indicate that it is expanded. Here, on this trigger, what I had, once the user clicks button number 2 on the base layer, button number 2 layer will show up. And as you may remember, I have button number 2 layer and button number 3 layer. This time, the button number 2 layer will show up because the user clicks on button number 2. On the base layer. This is the first action we want happen when the user clicks on button number 2. What other actions we want to happen if we think? I will cancel this out. And another trigger that I added here, for instance, to hide the button 2 base layer when the user clicks button 2 base layer. What it does basically, once the user clicks button number 2, then button number 2 layer will show up, right? But then I want to hide this button number 2 on the base layer. So this trigger actually makes that happen. The third action when the user clicks on button number 2 on base layer is to hide this little triangle on the base layer for button number 2. And so once the user clicks button number 2, it will change the state of button number 2 base layer triangle to hidden. So that on button number 2 layer, we won't see both button number 2 and it is triangle. This was for button number 2 on the base layer. And it is going to be the same or almost same for button number 3. Let's take a look at that too. Once user clicks button number 3 on the base layer, what will happen is button number 3 layer will show up, right? This is the first thing we want to happen. If we go ahead and take a look at the button number 3 layer, besides showing this layer, I want to hide button number 2 on the base layer and its triangle. I also would like to hide button number 3 and it is triangle on the base layer. These triggers do what I need from this interaction. It hides the button number 3 base layer triangle when the user clicks button number 3 on the base layer. And this one hides button 3 base layer when the user clicks button 3 on the base layer. And finally, it also will change the state of button 2 on the base layer to hidden when the user clicks button 3 on the base layer. So both of them will be hidden, both triangles will be hidden, and then this layer will be shown to the user. This is what happens. In the next section, we will take a look at what happens on the button 2 layer, for instance, if the user clicks the buttons. On the button 2 layer, there are a couple of options that the user might take. For instance, the users either click on button number 1 or button number 3. What we want to happen if the user clicks button number 1 when the user is on button number 2 layer, we want to hide this layer and show the base layer because button number 1 basically opens up the base layer. Once the user clicks again button number 1 on the button number 2 layer, then we want this layer to be hidden. This is the first thing. Then this next one we want to happen is we would like to change the state of button number 2 on the base layer to normal because we want to show the base layer to the user, right? So button number 2 on the base layer must be visible. And when we want this to happen, we want this happen when the user clicks on button number 1 on the button number 2 layer, which is this layer. And the next trigger says, let's change state of the button number 2 base layer triangle to normal when the user clicks button number 1 on button number 2 layer. These are the interactions for button number 2 on button number 2 layer. For button number 3 actions, we still want to hide this layer once the user clicks on button number 3 on button number 2 layer. This is the first thing. And we want to show layer button number 3, right? When the user clicks button number 2 on the button number 2 layer, we just hide one layer and show the layer we want users to see. But still, we need to add a couple more triggers because we want to still hide the button number 3 on the base layer when the user clicks on button number 3 on the button number 2 layer. In addition to that, we would like to change the state of triangle to hidden for button number 3 on the base layer when the user clicks on button number 3 on button 2 layer. And similar triggers I used for button number 3 as well. Overall idea is to hide whatever is unnecessary to button number 3 layer and then show the ones that aren't relevant to button number 3 layer. What I just remembered is I didn't really show you the states for the triangles that I used. Let me briefly mention that what kind of states that I used. This is the normal state for a triangle, and this is a what I called like down state for a triangle. And choose one of the triangles. As you see here, this is the normal state. But I created another state but the number two triangle down. So whenever I need to make that indication, I'm changing the states of the triangle to show what button is really expanded. To do that for the expanded button triangle, the initial state for the triangle is set for the downside. For instance, here for button number one, the triangle state is set to down. If you look at the states, you will see that initial state for the selected triangle is button number one underscore triangle underscore down. When I choose another triangle on the base layer for the collapsed button, the initial state would be then normal. For the button two layer, for instance, this time the button number one triangle on the button two layer, the state is set to normal. The initial state is normal here. So the basic idea is to set the state of the triangle based on the button layer that they will show up. If they are expanded, then the triangle state would be set to down, but otherwise it should be just normal. Before I finish my video, I would like to remind that you will be able to access this raw file. The link will be in the description area below this video, and I hope you will like it. And thank you very much for watching my video.